Namaste. My name is Simran and I have with me Dr. Gypsy Malhotra.
Namaste.
Together we are going to celebrate India's historical achievement, the landing of Chandrayaan 3 on the south side of the moon. With the theme Touching Lives While Touching the Moon, Indian Space Saga.
Thank you, Simran. Young or old, we all find moon fascinating and enchanting. 23rd August holds a special place in our hearts. And this year, we are going to celebrate the first National Space Day, commemorating the spectacular landing of Chandrayaan 3 on the south side of the moon.
That is so true. I remember as a child, I used to love watching the moon and have a lot of conversations about it with my parents.
Oh, really? Then I'm sure that when you will be watching the Rani story, you will be transported back to your childhood days.
Now, I'm very excited to see what is Rani's story.
So let's see it.
Dev, did you know our Naveen ji? He is planning to move away.
Really?
Oh yes, I remember last time when we met your Naveen uncle. He mentioned that he is looking for a quiet place to write. Maybe.
Maybe.
I think the moon would be perfect for Naveen uncle.
She's so cute.
And what made you say that, my love?
Because the moon is so quiet and peaceful, perfect for riding without distractions, huh?
She has a point.
Yes.
But indeed, it seems to be quiet. But the moon is much farther than it looks. And sadly, we just can't go there like we do with the planes in the sky.
But Papa, if we can see it, why can't we go there?
Beta, we can go there, but we need a special vehicle for that. A kind of a space rocket?
A space rocket? That sounds exciting, but why can't we live on the moon?
Because, Beta, the moon doesn't have air or water like we have on Earth. And it is really cold during the night and hot during the day. We need special equipment to survive.
Has anyone ever been there, Papa?
Of course, yes. People first went to the moon in the year 1969. But let me tell you one thing. It is still a very dangerous and a very, very challenging journey. Kudos to those who made it to the moon.
I can't.
And that's why missions like Chandrayaan 3 are important. They help us learn more about moon and future exploration.
Chandrayaan 3, what's that now?
It's an Indian mission, Beta, to explore the moon. In fact, this mission has helped India as well as the entire world to explore more about the space. You never know, one day we'll stay there longer.
Maybe I'll visit the moon someday.
Who knows? But now it's getting late. It's time for bed. Chalo, Beta, utho. You're getting late.
Aww, just a little longer.
I wish, Rani. But we have an early morning tomorrow. And your grandparents are visiting. I hope you remember, huh?
Oh, right. I almost forgot.
They love spending time with you, Beta. And we must be ready to welcome them.
Okay. Good night, Moon. Maybe I'll see you up close someday.
Good night, Rani. Do dream about rockets. Space adventures.
I will. Good night, Mama. Good night, Papa.
Bye-bye, Beta. Sweet dreams. Dr. Gypsy, you were so right. I remember having so many conversations like this with my parents. But when I was young, technology had not made such progress. Oh, look, Dr. Gypsy, the IVS line is flashing a call. So let's hear it.
Ma'am, how does the spacecraft travel from Earth to Moon?
Dr. Gypsy, would you like to answer this?
Sure, that's a great question. Let's imagine the spaceship is like a super strong ball that we want to throw up into the sky. But to throw it far enough, we reach space, we need really strong push. This is where rocket comes in. They give the spaceship the strong push. Now to understand how the spaceship move in the space, we need to thank scientist Kepler. In 16th century, Kepler used mathematical equations to prove the scientific community, the planets, etc., travel in the space in elliptical path. Kepler laws are like rules that help us to understand how things move around in the space. Kepler said that planets or other subspace objects do not move in perfect circles but in elliptical shapes. When we launch a spaceship, it starts moving in a big elliptical path around the Earth. This path helps it move smoothly as it travels in the space. Simran, do you know Kepler has also noticed that things move faster when they're closer to what they're orbiting around and slower when they're farther away. For our spaceship, as it gets farther from Earth, this is like how a swing moves faster at the bottom and slower at the top. So to get a spaceship into the space, rockets give it a big push to get started. Once it is moving, it follows these elliptical path and changes the speed just like Kepler rules says and move into the space. Simran, would you like to see the animation?
Of course.
Here it is. Oh, there is another caller on our IVRS. So let's hear it.
Ma'am, where was the Chandrayaan 3 launched from?
Chandrayaan 3 was launched from the Satish Dhawan Space Center located in Sriharikota, India.
Simran, is there anything special about Sriharikota that it was chosen for the launch?
Oh yes. Apart from having a stable climate, Sriharikota is a great place for launching space missions. One, it is located close to the equator, which is beneficial because rockets can use the Earth's rotational speed to gain an extra boost, saving on fuel. Also, as you see on the screen, Sriharikota's position on the east coast of India provides a clear launch path over the Bay of Bengal, which is important for safety. Any debris or launch issues can be safely managed over the ocean, away from populated areas. And do you know the Space Center is named after Dr. Satish Dhawan? Dr. Gypsy, if you visit the portal bharatonthemoon.ncert.gov.in, you could read more about him and some modules related to Chandrayaan 3.
That sounds so interesting. I will surely see that modules.
So Dr. Gypsy, how was Chandrayaan 3 launched from Satish Dhawan Space Center?
It was really an interesting journey. The Geosynchronous Satellite Launch Vehicle Mark 3, GSLV Mk3 M1, launch vehicle, also known as LVM-3, consists of several key components as solid rocket booster S200. LVM-3 is equipped with two large solid rocket boosters designated S200, which provide initial thrust needed to lift the rocket off the ground. These boosters burn solid propellants and are attached to the sides of the whole core stage. Another key component, core stage L110. It is powered by two Vikas engines that burn liquid propellant. On the above was solid propellant and here it is liquid propellant. It provides additional thrust after the solid rocket boosters are jettisoned. Another stage is cryogenic upper stage, known as C25. This is also called C25 cryogenic stage that uses liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen as the propellant. It is powered by CE20 engine, which provides necessary thrust to place the payload into the intended orbit. Next key element is payload fairing. This is a protective shell that encases the payload during the initial stages of the launch. It protects the spacecraft from the aerodynamic forces and the heat as the vehicle ascends through the atmosphere. Once the vehicle reaches space, the fairing is jettisoned to reduce the weight. Most important key element in our payload, the payload for specific mission is Chandrayaan 3 spacecraft, which includes a lander and a rover designed for lunar exploration. The lander is named Vikram after Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, the founder of Indian Space Research Organization. The name Vikram means valor or courage, symbolizing the bold step India is taking in space exploration. Once Vikram successfully landed on the moon, it deploys the rover called Pragyan. The name Pragyan comes from a Sanskrit word which means knowledge or wisdom. The rover is equipped with scientific instruments to study the moon's surface. It moves around analyzing the lunar soil and rocks and sending valuable data back to the Earth. This data helps scientists learn more about Moon's composition, surface properties, and environment. Together, Vikram and Pragyan are working together, as we both are working together, to provide us with the new insights and knowledge about our nearest celestial neighbor. These components work together in a staged sequence to successfully launch the spacecraft into the space, with each stage serving a specific purpose in the ascent and orbital insertion process.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Plus 5 seconds.
Lift off normal. P1 tracking.
R2 tracking.
P2 tracking. Stage performance normal.
P4 tracking.
L1 turn stage ignited.
Plus 2 minutes.
L1 turn stage performance normal. Hundred stages are separated. Close loop guidance initiated.
Simran, have you seen some amazing videos that ISRO has sent from Chandrayaan 3?
No, I haven't. Can you please show them?
Sure, let's play them. Dr. Gypsy, you said that Chandrayaan 3 was launched on 14th of July. Then why did it land on 23rd of August?
That's an interesting question. The reason Chandrayaan 3 took over a month to land over the moon is because it follows carefully planned route, which is called Lunar Transfer Trajectory. Let's break that down. After the spacecraft is launched, it doesn't just fly straight to the moon. It starts orbiting the Earth and gradually moves farther away. This gradual movement is achieved through a series of engine burns, which help the spacecraft increase its speed and altitudes in the stages. The method is efficient and safe fueling. After reaching a high enough orbit, the spacecraft then performs a precise maneuver to align itself with the moon's orbit. This phase is called lunar orbit insertion, where the spacecraft slows down and enters the moon's gravitational field. This step is crucial because it allows the spacecraft to be captured by the moon's gravity instead of just flying past it. Once in the lunar orbit, the spacecraft circles the moon multiple times. During this period, it adjusts its path and position, preparing for the landing phase. This involves fine-tuning its orbit to ensure a safe descent. The spacecraft then moves closer to the moon's surface in a controlled manner. Each of these steps from the initial Earth orbit to the final descent requires careful planning and timing. So the process may take several weeks, but it is essential for ensuring spacecraft lands safely and precisely. So while it might seem like a long time,
but each day is used to carefully navigate and prepare for a successful mission.
Simran, we seem to have another caller on the line.
Ma'am, what is the aim behind sending Chandrayaan 3 to Moon?
Dr. Gypsy, let's answer this question.
Sure. After almost 50 years since the US Apollo mission to the Moon, there has been a new rising interest in the Moon. This renewed interest started the discovery of ice in the southern polar region, which has been firmly established. The presence of ice implies the presence of water, which can be potentially be separated into hydrogen and oxygen, both of which are valuable rocket fuels. This opens up the possibility of building rockets on the Moon and utilizing locally produced fuel for the future space missions. The advantage lies in the fact that launching deep space mission from Moon is easier and more cost-effective than due to its lower gravity. This would have been economically impractical if the rocket fuel has to be transported from Earth to Moon.
Before we end this program, Dr. Gypsy, we must see an inspiring clip by our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi when he congratulated all scientists of ISRO and celebrated Bharat on the Moon.
Friends, on this joyous occasion, I would like to address all the people of the world, the people of every country and region. India's successful moon mission is not just India's alone. This is a year in which the world is witnessing India's G20 presidency. Our approach of one earth, one family, one future is resonating across the globe. This human-centric approach that we present and that we represent has been welcome universally. Our moon mission is also based on the same human-centric approach. Therefore, this success belongs to all of humanity, and it will help moon missions by other countries in the future. I am confident that all countries in the world, including those from the global south, are capable of achieving such feats. We can all aspire for the moon and beyond.
India is on the moon. On 23rd August 2023, Chandrayaan 3 made the historic landing on the moon. The Vikram, as well as the Pragyan, made history. This 23rd August 2024, we are celebrating the National Space Day announced by our Honorable Prime Minister to commemorate the landing on the moon, the historic landing on the moon. Celebrations across the country organized, culminating in the first anniversary celebration of this historic day at New Delhi. I wish all of you join this celebration, be part of this celebration, and have the Space Day, the maiden Space Day, celebrated all across the country with great enthusiasm and joy. Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining with us. Let's celebrate the first National Space Day together. Namaste.